हेलो एवरीवन, माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर प्रोफेसर विठोबा थोरात। दिस टाइम आई एम गोइंग टू डील विद योर पेपर फर्स्ट, दैट इज लिटररी क्रिटिसिज्म। एज इट इज इनएविटेबल फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस नाउ, because we are all going through a pandemic which has made us to anyhow to carry on with our syllabus, right? So in this situation we are all unable to gather physically to listen the classes, so that is why we are going to conduct online mode classes for you all, for all convenience, right? Till when our government gives us permission to start colleges. Okay. So now, as I have said earlier, I am going to deal with your paper first, that is optional paper first, literary criticism. You might have heard the word called literary criticism, or if you didn't hear, I'll tell you what it is that. But before that, we're all familiar with the word called literature. Literature, what is literature? Right? So, literary criticism is as old as literature, right? We can say that there are many discussions, debates which happened regarding the literary criticism and literary creativity or literature, right? You can ask the first question that what is first, literature first or criticism first? Right? The question arises here, a creative writer produces a work of art, but who gives a critic the right to criticize his work? Right? The writer has laid down many efforts to produce a kind of work, a kind of literary work. Right? So this is also a question which arises in the minds of us, but that is secondary. But now let us see literary criticism. As some of the authors have come to conclusion that literary criticism is also as old as literary creativity. There is creative faculty and critical faculty, right? In this class, let me tell you what is literary criticism, right? We know what is literature, then let us say what is literary criticism. Before literary criticism, let us say what is criticism, right? The word criticism was derived from Greek word kritikos, which means to judge. Here the word criticism has been derived from the word, that is Greek word called kritikos. That means to judge. To judge means what? To judge a work of art. To judge a literature work. Maybe it is novel, poetry or something else. Any genre of the literature. Right? So now here, we should think what exactly literary criticism does. See? For what it is necessary. See, a creative writer himself is a first critical thinker. Right? He should think himself before producing a literary work of art. Right? So that is why I said in the beginning that criticism is also as old as literary creativity. Right? So literature means what? Judgment, evaluation, right? Comments, right? Literary critic comments on the work of art. Finding faults, finding merits and demerits, suggestion to the writers. Even criticism here serves as a mediator between the reader and the work. Right? About the work, criticism discusses. Right? And that discussion can be read by the reader. That reader will understand about the particular work of literature. Suppose there is a big novel. Before reading that novel, a reader goes through that review, goes through that comments. That is what. So in this way, criticism helps the reader. Right? So, and while producing a work of art, while writing a literary work, some points might have missed. So those points can be, we can say them as a silent matters. Those which have been made silent can be raised by the critic, can be said to the writer or can be said to the reader, right? So this is what, you know, criticism, it is very essential to, you know, to make a work of art effective on the reader, right? To gain its value, right? So that is why criticism is essential. See, you can get the answer for the question, which one is first? Why? Who gave the right to the critic to criticize the work of art? Because it is, he is result of efforts. The writer himself has put a lot of efforts to produce this kind of work. So, if he has rights, see, the writer has a right to produce, but it does not mean that whatsoever which comes to his mind to write in a paper piece, that must be valuable, that must contribute to the society something else, that must, you know, produce values, that must inculcate the values in the minds of readers, that must take the society onto the right path. So this is one of the great function of the literature. So that is why we should give prominence to the literary criticism, right? So this is what literature, right? You might have got the idea. As I have mentioned here, this is introductory class about the literary criticism, right? So here I will stop, and if you have any doubts, you can raise me by call or in WhatsApp messages. Okay, thank you.